Hello, I'm Mr. R. Najjar, a retired lecturer in Mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. I'm writing a book on one God, one faith. And this is chapter 6, belief and faith, the distinction between them, you know. Most people do not care to differentiate between belief and faith. And therefore, such messages as have faith in God, when people do not act according to gospel, make no sense. Belief called deen in Urdu is the forerunner of faith called EEMAN. Thus, you act according to your beliefs and your deeds generate faith in what you had believed in. And if you happen to follow others without having your own beliefs, then you are blind believers. Then you are a blind believer. And have a blind faith as well. So you need to be sure what you are believing in. On the other hand, those who act in accordance with the gospel are said to be the enlightened believers. And their faith is not blind. In short, the people who understand the gospel and put it into practice believe in God and they have a faith in God. Thus, those people who have a deep faith in God are given a greater ability to understand gospel. So, once you get the taste of gospel, you know, then you get more of it. The significance of belief and faith is well stressed by Christ Jesus. In the parable of sower, in which Jesus or his apostles are the sowers of his word, the seed, whilst the capacity of understanding his word and transforming it into belief is depicted by the various types of people or the depths of soil. This parable also outlines the characteristics of the three members of Trinity or the three types of people known as helic, the people of flesh, natural man, psychic, twice born, and the clever people of evil spirit. They are clever people of evil spirit. With doubting minds and pneumatic, the people of Holy Spirit who have firm faith in God. Or we said are sealed to serve God. In Matthew 13, verse 33, these three types of people also form the three layers of flower into which the woman, our Mother Holy Spirit, hid the leaven of His word to form a huge single loaf of bread. The body of Jesus, the Church of God congregation. His body is of Jesus, not of Christ. Blood is of Christ. Thus we have in St. Luke 8 verse 5, a sower, Jesus, and his roving apostle went out to sow, preach sowing is preaching his seed. And as he sowed into the hearts of people, some fell by the wayside or footpath. This type of soil represents the once born helic people of the flesh, who are incapable of understanding or grasping his word because they are numbly led by the natural animal instincts. Such people normally respond to child psychology, and they will go by the tit-for-tat moral laws of Moses because they lack spirit to understand the gospel. Their deeds are governed by blind faith. That is, for example, the widow's mite and the cheating of the simpletons by the American televangelist. So they are getting, you know, in America they are cheating them and they are living lavishly themselves at the price of those poor people. It was trodden down. Gospel being for the sensible people of spirit, the helic people would interpret it by the very letters of gospel, which leads to misinterpretations. For example, the most pious married Samaritan woman of John 4, Samaritan woman at well, John 4, is proclaimed by the theologians of the letters as a prostitute. And Matthew 19, the parable of so-called marriage and divorce, is also very much misinterpreted. This is called the treading over the precious pearls of gospel. And the fowls of air, sensible people of spirit, devoured it, picked up the sense out of the utterances made by the helic men of letters. And they took the gospel to their hearts to generate faith. So they enjoyed it in the birds of the air. And some fell down upon rocky soil. These are the twice born people of spirit who have the ability to understand the gospel, but they lack confidence or faith in God, and half-heartedly they put his word into practice. That is, their faith in God is not firm or deep rooted, but doubting. So they are like listener, you know, they listen. They haven't confidence of preaching. So these people normally put their gospel under bushel, not on lampstand. Their faith is rather as shallow as the rocky soil. Such person cannot stand the testing times, and therefore as soon as the plant of faith sprung up and faced the prince of darkness, it withered away, left the way of God, because the person lacked guts, the moisture. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up with it and choked it. These are also the twice born persons of Holy Spirit who understand gospel, believe in and put into practice his word through preaching. That is, they have full faith in God, but being involved in the secular world of mammon, the worldly temptations are the worldly affairs, the thorns that do not let them make a headway. Thus, these are the pneumatics which go by the logic, and they do not exploit the once-born simpletons, but their faith in God is choked by the worldly temptations or the secular affairs. And other fell on good ground. These are the pneumatic who have set themselves free of the mammon, and thus the worldly temptations, by selling their personal possessions and renouncing the ways of secular world in order to become the apostles or roving preachers in honor of their elder brother and bridegroom, Christ Jesus. Such people have pledged their lives to serve God only. Matthew 4, verse 10. Then saith Jesus unto him, Get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Father God, and him only. Remember that our Father God is our Father, not Lord. Lords, they have slaves. Slaves are not allowed into the house, only the sons. That is why in the parable of 10 virgins, the 5 virgins, when they knocked at the door of our Father, they said, Father, Father, Abba, Abba. And he said, Come in, sons, no problem. The other psychic, you know, they wanted to praise him, glorify him. They said, they knocked at the door, said, Lord, Lord. He said, Oh, get lost. No lords in this, in here. Here is a freedom and no binding anyone. No slaves allowed into my house. So he threw them out. And him only shall thou serve. Also the rich young man who wanted to be perfect, Jesus advised him to give his property to the poor for perfection. This man, you know, he cheated the poor people to become rich. So give the cheat, what you have cheated, back to the poor, and you are square one. Thus, but he loved the mammon. Thus they receive his word free and in abundance. And unlike the present clerics, who are the hirelings of mammon, they preach the gospel free from the core of their hearts and not teach the dead letters as they do in the universities. And sprang up and bear fruit and bear fruit and hundredfold. 100 is the best one that one can attain, meaning that such devoted pneumatics enter the bridal chamber and attain the perfection through the gifts of Holy Spirit as they received at Pentecost. In brief, the helix, being the men of flesh, they could easily be misled by the evil-spirited sons of Satan and turned into fanatics. Thus the helix bear no fruit. The evil-spirited psychics called the hypocrite fathers understand his word, but their lack of faith in God and their selfish nature and temptations of mammon could easily lure them into the kingdom of Satan. For example, Judas Iscariot, the thief who stole money from the purse, as these hireling dog-collared priests in churches do today as their salaries in mammon. For their doubts, the the psychics who normally put light under the bushel bear bear 30% fruit, whilst the seal to serve God nomadics who are still involved in the secular world bear 60% of fruit. So those who go to wilderness as Jesus and his laborer went, John the Baptist went to wilderness, so they bore 100% fruit. They gave full devotion to God. So I will leave it here. The video is getting big.